A season of hope and progress ended with a thud at the Military Bowl as Virginia went down to Navy 49-7. Still a 6-win campaign that got the program to postseason play for the first time in quite a few years. We bring in Matt Trogdon from Streaking the Lawn. You can catch him on SB Nation's platform for Virginia Athletics. Of course, subscribe to my YouTube channel for the very best in college football coverage across the nation. Matt, how you doing today?
Hey, Mark, I'm good. Thanks for having me. It's great to be back.
How do you take and how do does the fan base take the late season slide, but the overall picture of progress?
That's a great question, Mark. And thanks again. It's really a mixed bag for Virginia fans, I think, this season. I don't think anybody who's being honest with themselves really envisioned the team getting 6 wins. I know I certainly didn't. I had them with 4. My previous season prediction, I had 4 wins. So 6 was definitely a much larger step forward than I think a lot of fans would have expected. And they had a great win early on in the season against Boise State. And they beat North Carolina for the first time in 7 years. So that was a nice slide to end. But it's hard not to it's hard to ignore the late season swoon. I mean, the team started off 5-1 and they ended up 6-7. And they got blown out in the bowl game against Navy. And, after halftime against Miami, they didn't score another offensive touchdown for the rest of the season. So definitely a mixed bag. I think they're, is still some enthusiasm, but it's much more tempered than it probably would have been if they could have picked off one of those last 3 games, either Miami or Virginia Tech or Navy. The Navy game, it was a lot of fun to go to Annapolis and cheer them on, and we had a lot of fun up until kickoff, and then they returned the kickoff for the opening kickoff for a touchdown, 7-0, and then Navy got the ball and wheels kind of came off after that. So really, like you said, a thud to end the season. And I think it probably tempers a lot of the enthusiasm that might have been built up earlier in the year.
Yeah, it was one of those matchups where you have one of the rare Power 5 versus a group of 5 with what you would think would be a decided athletic advantage, speed, power, guys that would move on to the next level. And even in those guys that didn't, higher ranked in terms of recruiting in the transition from high school to college, but a difficult assignment against a team that runs a triple option and is very fundamentally sound, and just an intriguing matchup from that standpoint. But what was gathered from yourself, the players, the coaches, based on the post-game comments about why such a disparity? Why such a lopsided game?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think the weather had an impact. It was something like 19 degrees at kickoff, and Virginia offensively was a much more passing-oriented team this season. And the cold weather really kind of makes the passing game a lot harder to operate. Navy, I don't think they completed a pass in the game, so that certainly didn't affect them. So Virginia really couldn't move the ball offensively. Defensively, I was really surprised at how easily Navy kind of carved the UVA defense up. I really thought, especially after UVA had played Georgia Tech well defensively, I thought that they were going to do something similar against Navy. There was a little chatter that a couple of the Virginia players might have walked through the Navy warm-up line before the game, and that might have fired up the midshipmen a little bit more, and that might have led to a little bit more inspiration on their side, and that might have contributed to the blowout. But that's hard to say if that really happened or not.